Hey guys, Zander here, and in this video, let's see how to clean a very old PC. So basically, my friend told me that his PC is not starting at all, and he never opened it since he bought it, and it's been years that he bought it. And in my mind, I was like, yes, a new video. In this video, I'm going to disassemble all parts step by step and assemble them once again, which you may not have to do if your case is not this dirty. If you can get the dust out by using the first step, which I'm going to tell you guys right now, it's completely fine. You don't have to disassemble the complete PC. But it's always great to watch someone else do it, so don't forget to watch the complete video. I'm going to use a vacuum cleaner to remove all the dust present in the PC, and I guess I shouldn't call it dust because it's so much more than that. We are going to use the blower functionality and not the suction functionality of the vacuum cleaner, and you can use any blower in this case. And let me tell you that do not use suction functionality of your vacuum cleaner while cleaning your PC, even if you feel like doing it. Do not do it. It may damage your PC afterwards. If you don't have a blower, then you can use a cycle pump to clean everything. And I used to use the cycle pump earlier, but I recently bought a vacuum cleaner. And do not take it very close to the motherboard or any of the parts. Keep a safe distance. If you don't have a blower or pump, then use the old school method of using a brush. It will work like a charm too, but it will take a lot of time. Once I cleared all the superficial dust with vacuum cleaner, it was time to remove the motherboard. And I had to remove motherboard in this case because this guy did not open the case for 3 to 4 years and the dust is accumulated on the motherboard plus in the CPU fan too. If you think that your PC is clean enough, then do not worry. Just remove the RAM stick and reinsert it once again and you should be good enough. But the PC I'm working with will not start like that. Now it's time to remove this fan thing or CPU, which is most damaged by dust. And in my opinion, the fan is the reason why this PC is not starting at all. The stock Intel cooler has arrows marked on it, which makes it easy to remove them. And removing them is far more easier than putting them back. This is the thermal paste, which has become a total solid material after years of usage. For the best thermal performance, you should replace the thermal paste once in a year or two. And as you can see, the CPU fan has so much dust inside it. I was totally surprised by the amount of dust which is present in this fan, and no wonder the PC was not starting. Now we need to remove the wire connections, and as this is an old PC, I have no idea about the motherboard manual, so I took a photo of the connections so that it will be easy to reassemble them. So remove all the screws which are holding the motherboard in place, and those are 3 in my case. Keep those very safely. Pull out the motherboard and keep it on a non-metallic surface, which is another motherboard box in this case. Use any type of brush. If you do not have this brush, then you can use any dry, hear me once again, any dry toothbrush too, to clean the motherboard. And just rub the motherboard with the brush gently. Do not use any type of force to do this. Once you think that the motherboard is clean enough and looks good to your eye, you're good to go. Once again, I used the blower functionality of the vacuum cleaner to clean this thing, and all the dust was gone after 5 minutes of hard work. Finally, it looks good and I am pretty much sure that it should start working now. Now we need to remove the thermal paste which is present on this CPU cooler and on the processor. And you can remove the processor by this clip, and I would suggest you to take a picture of the processor too, just in case if you forget how to align the processor once again. You should do that if you think that you will not be able to remember that. I know how to put a processor, so that's why I did not do that. And now we need to clear the solid thermal paste from the CPU cooler as well as the CPU. And the thermal paste is so solid that, oh my god, it was so difficult to remove it. I tried to use a plastic too, but still the thermal paste was not coming out. And to clean this, use any type of clean cloth and 99% alcohol. I'll give the link of that in the description box below. You can buy that from Amazon, or you can get it in the medical shops directly too. Just go ahead and ask them for 99% alcohol or something like that. Do not use beer or alcohol which you drink, because that's not pure alcohol. I did not invest much time in cleaning everything completely, but I made sure that the surface is even, because we are going to put a new thermal paste on it. Now remove the clip, put the processor in place, and these two markings will help you to recognize how to put the CPU back on this place. If you had clicked the picture, then look at that picture and do it once again, because you do not want to mess with the CPU, because it is one of the costliest part in the current build, or any build for that matter. Unless until you are making a PC build, which I made earlier. And now we need to put the thermal paste. And if you do not have thermal paste at your home, which you will not have, I'll give the direct link to some very good thermal paste from Amazon.in in the description box below. Do not forget to buy from that if you want to buy a good thermal paste for your CPU. Now put the thermal paste, and this is a little too much, so I ended up removing the thermal paste. Even if you put a little bit of extra thermal paste, it's okay, but you do not need to do that, because even if you put this much of thermal paste, it's completely fine and it is going to work the same way, or it will remain cool overall. And now it's time to put the cooler on this thing. Pull out all the four pins which are present on this cooler, and now put the cooler on the CPU. Push all these pins once again and rotate them so that it will be in place. It may take you a little bit of extra time to do this if you are doing it for the first time, and it may not fit perfectly in the first attempt. Do not worry, try it once again. Even I take 2 or 3 attempts in order to put the stock cooler on this CPU, because Intel stock coolers can be tricky at times. And if you think that while putting the cooler on the CPU and while removing it, you put the thermal paste on the motherboard or something like that, do not panic. It's not going to harm your motherboard, or it's not going to harm your CPU at all. But do not do that. Once that's done, let's put the RAM stick in place, and that's the most easy part in my opinion. Just pull these knobs out, put the RAM stick inside, and the RAM stick will fit in automatically. You do not have to do anything. Now let's take the motherboard and put it inside the case. If you want to clean the case once again, then use the blower functionality of your vacuum cleaner and clean it once again, or use the brush in order to remove all the remaining dust in that particular case. I cleaned the hard disk too, but be very, very gentle, guys, while cleaning the hard disk. You do not want to damage this. If you are not using SSD in your build, then I don't know why you are not doing that. I'm not going to add SSD in this case, because this is my friend's case and not my case actually. And this is very old PC, as you saw. You should be using SSD in your PC build, because it will reduce the boot time to 10 to 20 seconds, or all the app opening or game opening times will be reduced to half in my opinion, or even less than that. So use SSD if you aren't already. Links for those are in the description box below. Now let's put the motherboard back into the case and put all the screws, 3 in my case, on the motherboard. Now it's time to put all the connections back in place. Wires marked with audio and USB are very easy to put, because on the motherboard there are markings which says audio and USB. But when it comes to these connections, the picture which we took earlier is going to help us a lot. So don't forget to use that picture and do these connections properly, because you do not want to do it in a wrong way. And even if you misplace some pins, it is not going to harm your PC. It is not going to blow up. Do not worry. It's just that your PC will not start unless and until you put those correctly. So put those correctly. Why? Put the hard disk in place. Screw it properly. Check all the connections on the motherboard once again, and make sure that you are giving power cable to the hard disk too. If you have graphics card in your build, which is quite obvious, I did not show you how to clean it because it was not present in this build. Then just remove the graphics card and clean it gently with the blower by holding the fan, as I did with the CPU. Do not let the fan spin while you use the blower. And just put it back into the place. You can clean the PCB of the graphics card gently with a brush. And now we have put everything back into the place. And now the case looks so much cleaner with no dust and everything like that. And I hope that it is going to start, because if the problem is in motherboard or in the processor or something is outdated, then the PC will not start at all. But let's try to do it. And earlier the CPU fan was not starting at all, like it used to spin and then used to stop. But this time the CPU's fan is rotating, so that's a good sign. And yes, the PC has started. Finally. I'm really glad that it started. And this hard disk error, like CHK, DSK, check disk error is there. Most probably because he has some fishy games or something like that on the PC, and he did not open it or he did not start it in months. I am not sure about that though. But the CHK DSK thing or check disk thing completed in 5 to 10 minutes, and after that the PC started and booted into the Windows 7. Hooray! Finally, we have booted the PC successfully in Windows 7, and I'm really, really glad, and I was really happy that it started up. And the speed which he is going to experience after cleaning everything, which includes only CPU in this case, is going to be different as compared to with dust. And when you clean your old PC, you'll notice a little bit of speed difference too. Plus, when you clean the PC, you'll notice that the CPU is running at lower temperatures, plus the graphics card is running at very low temperatures as compared to earlier when it had a lot of dust in it. So yeah, this is pretty much it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up if you liked it. And if you think that I should make more PC content like this, then let me know about that in the comment section box below. Or don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video and if you want me to make more videos. I did not show how to disassemble a graphics card or a power supply because I think that it's like too advanced for this particular video. But I can do that too because I have done that earlier with my PC. So if you want those videos, then let me know about that in the comment section box below. Don't forget to click on my face right now and get subscribed because many more awesome videos like these are going to come real soon on the channel. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.